it almost takes someone who's gone through it to sit and start to finish, be able to compare notes and say, oh yeah, that happened to me, or nope, I haven't had that happen. I was shaving and I noticed a bump on my neck. I had to find an ENT and was told of the diagnosis. And it's one of those days where you're sitting in the lobby talking to your wife, thinking about what you're gonna have for lunch, and 20 minutes later, you're talking about what your survivability is. For head and neck, it sort of tests you in the fact that you have to wear a mask to be treated, to hold your head perfectly still, set all their markers for where the machine does its wonders and treats the areas that need to be treated and tries to stay away from those that do not. You can talk to a radiologist and say, we get more and more cases of head and neck cancer on men from HPV virus, but you don't see the cancer support groups getting any bigger.
I just think it's overwhelming when you're going through this to begin with. You know, having that diagnosis alone is enough to shut anybody down. It's an educational meeting, but afterwards people stay around for, you know, 45 minutes to an hour and start exchanging information or just talking about what they're going through. The patients are finding a much better quality of life than they would have had otherwise.
A lot of them were just like me. They were totally ignorant to the fact that everybody seems to go through the same type of thing. You didn't feel like you were alone with your problems. Everybody had their own ideas of, oh, here's how you can alleviate this little problem, and here's what made this better for me, and you might want to try this. And it just made it easier to deal with the recovery. If you were to interview every person in the cancer group, their stories would all be a little different. Some people probably could swallow a little, but there were a couple that, you know, had the same experience I did, that you couldn't swallow anything. If I would have known that there was a cancer support group and people that were knowledgeable in the after effects of all these things, I would have attended those and probably learned a lot more and made this a little easier process to deal with.
But I don't think anybody can really fathom how their life is going to change until it happens.
Once diagnosed, if you can find a cancer support group, it's easier to find an entire checklist of things that you want to be mindful of going into your treatments. But the main part is that you can go through it and make it and come out with a new normal. I mean, it's not exactly the same, but it's certainly the next best thing.